GenerateBlocks is fast improving its suite of elements, but one you've probably been missing all of this time is a modal, or a popup as it's sometimes called. So I went in search of a solution that balances functionality, ease of use, and accessible as a popup can be, and I think I've found the right balance from a GitHub repo that goes by the name of histmodal. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to get histmodal working in GenerateBlocks Pro, but as long as your builder of choice allows you to add classes and custom attributes, you can pretty much add this to anything, whether it's Oxygen or Bricks, or maybe even something like Cwicly as well. So we're gonna jump right into adding the code. In my case, I'm going to use WPCodeBox to add this custom code, and we're going to create two snippets. The first one is just going to be the JavaScript for this modal itself, and we'll just simply call this snippet modal.js. And in terms of the settings we're going to configure, we'll set the script type to JavaScript, how to render to external, script tag to async, script location to footer, snippet order to 10, and where to run front end, or you can even configure it as a custom condition if you prefer that. Then you can just paste in the code, which you can get at the link in the description below. While you're there, please consider subscribing to my email list. I don't send things very often, but what I do send is summaries of new tutorials, things that are interesting I find across the internet that will be applicable to you. And of course, just like everybody, I promise not to spam you. So go ahead and grab that JavaScript from the page, paste it in this snippet, save, and turn it on. Now we're going to create a second snippet inside of WPCodeBox, and this one we're going to call modal CSS. For the settings, we're going to choose script type of CSS, how to render will be external file, script location of footer, snippet order of 10, and again, where to run will either be front end, or you can set a custom condition here if you'd like. I've modified this CSS somewhat from the original GitHub repo to work for your GenerateBlocks Pro site, but it's super simple and easy to read as you can see, so if you want to customize it further, you absolutely can do that. Again, be sure to save the snippet and turn it on. Histmodal gives us a sample HTML markup of how to make this modal work and what attributes and classes are required. Essentially, we're going to have three divs. One is going to act as the wrapper, one will be the background overlay, and one will be the final div, which is essentially your modal content. Again, at the link in the description, I've copied my GenerateBlocks layout there for you to just copy and paste right into your site. So if you're not interested in fiddling around with all the classes and attributes, you can just go ahead and dump that right into your page and get rolling. In my case, I created it as a GenerateBlocks element because I have more control over where it's going to appear on my site, and I'm not loading code unnecessarily. Now, in terms of the structure of these elements, if you decide to make changes or build it on your own, these are the things that you need to pay attention to most. Your parent container needs to be a div and its ID set to my modal. It also needs to have a class called histmodal and a custom attribute set to aria-hidden equals true. Now, the JS that we added earlier is going to handle automatically switching that aria attribute from true to false based on your modal's visibility. Your second div needs to have a class called histmodalWrap and a minimum height of 100 VH, so your modal is centered on the page. Your third div contains all of your modal content, but it needs a few attributes and classes as well. It needs a class called histmodal __window, it needs a role equals dialogue attribute, and it needs an aria-modal equals true attribute. Next up, you need a button that's going to handle the opening and closing of this, which is your trigger. Its href link can just be set to a pound sign, and it needs an attribute of data-histmodal equals --mymodal, where that mymodal is the ID you set on your parent container in step two. So essentially, the IDs of your button trigger and your parent container just need to match to make the modal actually open. Lastly, you're going to need a close button, and this simply is going to have a class called histmodal __close, and then it's going to have an attribute of just data-histclose, and that will make the button work. The CSS we added earlier is going to handle the styling and position of that button for you. After that, you can add anything you want to your third div, like I've said. You can even style that third div to have rounded corners, box shadows, any background color you want, and that will be, you know, reflected on the front end in that modal after you've published those changes. There are two minor things you might want to change in the code snippets we created earlier. Firstly, in the CSS snippet we created is the color of the overlay. The classes to look for are called HistModalShadow and HistModalShadowShow. You can change the background color on the Shadow class and the opacity value on the ShadowShow class to your liking. Secondly, you can look in the JS file for the backscroll is true or false. That just enables or disables the background scroll if you put your mouse over there and scroll up and down outside of the modal. You should probably just leave it as is, because if the modal gets too tall, you're going to end up with two scroll bars on your page. So you would have to adjust the minimum height of your second div, which of course we set earlier to 100 VH. And that's it. You now have a totally functional modal pop-up in your site. Doesn't have to necessarily be GenerateBlocks, but it can be any of those. Now, of course, I specialize in GenerateBlocks and GeneratePress. So if you're interested in learning more, please consider checking out my Generate Made Easy course at the link in the description below. My name is Jonathan, and as always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in a future video.